Apple announced two brand new 35W dual-port USB-C charger at WWDC 22, and today we got the compact version. I know you've been waiting for the teardown of this charger, so let's start today's video. The pure white packaging continues the Apple design, the product name and Apple logo are in the upper left corner. Flip to the back, you can insert two USB-C cables into this charger. Open the box, there is only a charger without the cable. The top and side of the charger adopt glossy white shell with rounded corners. The slight hollows on two sides can facilitate the user to hold it more tightly. Two white USB-C output ports are side by side, pretty special. The input prongs of this charger are foldable but not removable. The specs info is at the bottom, model is A2579. It can support wide range input of 100-240V, 50 or 60 Hz, and output of 12V, 1.75A, 15V, 2.33A, 9V, 3A, 5V, 3A. The manufacturer is Salcomp Technology. The size of this charger is about 49x49x28mm, and the weight is about 104 grams. Compared to the previous Apple 30W charger, the size is smaller but has two USB-C ports, which is an obvious improvement for Apple chargers. The ChargerLab Power ZKT002 shows the USB-C can only support PD 3.0 and the maximum power is 35W. It can support 4 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 2.33A, and 12V, 1.75A. The specs of those two USB-C ports are the same. Okay, the next step is to take it apart to check what's inside. Remove the outer plastic and take out the internal PCB module. The back of the PCB is covered with a plastic module for fixing, and the PCB module is fixed by clips, which is pretty hard to remove. A thermal pad is under the plastic module for heat dissipation. ChargerLab found the Synchronous rectifier, V-bus switch MOSFET, and other components on the back are symmetrical, and the front components adopt the same design. This charger has two identical switching power supply circuits which adopt QFY-back topology. When you charge only one device, two circuits are connected in parallel and can be up to 35W. When you charge two devices at once, the power is distributed independently according to the devices. Let's start from the input to introduce all components. Firstly, the AC input socket is soldered to the PCB and connected to the prongs by metal plates. The special design can make it more convenient to replace different prongs in different regions during mass production. The first common mode choke is in here and connected to the second common mode choke. And here is the second one. It is wound with red and copper colored wires. And then the AC input fuse is from SCHURTER for overcurrent protection, where the current is 2.5 amp. Here is a fast recovery bridge rectifier, which is from LITE-ON MRS30M, 3A, 1000 volts. There are three primary electrolytic capacitors in total. All of those capacitors can convert poles to DC into pure DC. Two of them are from AiSHi, 400 volts, 22 microfarad. The third one is from CapXon, 10 microfarad, 400 volts. The differential mode choke is next to the AC input socket. After introducing the EMI filter circuit, here are two mass control chips marked with ZN1431C. It's the customized model for Apple from Power Integrations. It integrates primary controller, switch transistor, and synchronous rectification controller. Here are two identical RCD clamp circuits used to absorb the current in the leakage transformer inductance. And two transformers are manufactured by Salcomp. After removing the transformers, two black safety X capacitors are hidden under them. Two synchronous rectifiers are from AOS and adopt DFN5+6 package, 100 volts, 6.3 milliohm. It is controlled by mass control chip for synchronous rectification. Those two solid capacitors are from CapXon used for output filtering, 560 microfarad, 25 volts. Two MOSFETs are from ON Semiconductor and adopt WDFN8 package, 30 volts, 2.9 milliohm. The upper PCB is connected to the main PCB through this small solder joint. A protocol chip is soldered on the back of the upper PCB, used to identify protocol and control the upper voltage of two USB-C ports. It comes from Infineon CCG4 series and adopts QFN6x6 package. It integrates a 32-bit ARM M0 processor, 128KB flash memory, and 8KB memory. It also supports dual-port USB PD fast charging, which can be used for many devices. Two USB-C ports are soldered on the other side of the upper PCB. Well, that's all the components of this charger. It's completely different from the traditional Apple charger from the outside to the inside. After taking it apart, we found it adopts a special design to easily replace different prongs in different regions during mass production. And it also has two identical switching power supply circuits. So most components on the front and back are symmetrical. When you charge only one device, two circuits are connected in parallel and can be up to 35 watts. When you charge two devices at once, the power is distributed independently according to the devices. Okay, that's all for today's video. We'll have a performance test of this charger coming soon, so please subscribe to us and stay tuned. See you in the next video. Bye!